G'day folks. Well, I want to make a mention to the guys that commented on my last video. Thanks guys, it really helped me. I was really struggling when I put that video up. It really shocked me, it really did. I wasn't expecting it at all. And for you guys to comment, and I think a couple of yous there even mentioned that you've had the similar experiences. Don't worry, you'll bounce back. You know, it was really nice. I really liked it, you know, and it sort of cheered me up a little bit. So thanks, guys, for that. Well, guys, it did throw me. I wasn't expecting it. 23 or 4 years I've had this motor for. 6 years I've had it sort of boosted. And it's been a little champ, it really has. I've sort of kept the revs fairly conservative. I've never over-revved it, but sort of kept the boost relatively conservative too, you know, and I'm always very cautious about things. So when this sort of happens, it tends to throw you. And you just, at the time before I sort of pulled it apart, I was really emotional. I really was. It was unreal. That's the first time I've actually had an engine fail to that level. So it's always a first, but I'm actually quite relaxed now, guys. I really feel sort of just at ease. I know what the problem is. I'll share with it. Share it with you guys. Sorry. Let's have a little look at it. It's not nice, it's quite nasty, but there is a silver lining at the end of it, guys, so it is all good at the end of the day. All right, folks, well, I'm going to show you. I've left the motor in there. I haven't bothered pulling it out. I just sort of pulled the heads off it and started on the sort of tear down. We've got a piston there, guys, sitting there all beat up and stuffed. Well, it's number 4. This is where it's all sort of happened. We've got some nasty cracking or sort of fatigue in the bore. So basically what's happened is, guys, we've had a rupture in the bore, which has created a huge hydrolock up in the revs. And it's basically torn the piston apart, bent the conrod fairly heavily, and it's just completely destroyed that cylinder. And, oh God, what a fail that is. But check it out. Check this out. Look how thin the bore is there. You'd be lucky to be 2 mil thick, so you'd be lucky to be 80 thousandths thick, that bore. Now, this... what's happened here is actually there's been a bit of a telltale sign, guys. What's happened is leading up to this, and I've only just discovered it. I was actually talking to a friend of mine on the phone today. Tim, his name is. G'day, mate. And we sort of come to the conclusion that I've had small water issues leading up to what's happened. When I was at the track, guys, I went to start it and it sort of like hydrolocked on the starter motor, just like as if there's too much timing. It's just sort of, well, it may have even just backfired, you know, ignited and sort of because of the compression rise with water in it. And it sort of backfired on me. Didn't think much of it and gave it another go and she fired up. But I've been having trouble with it. Fouling, well, sort of misfiring until it warms up. I get a lot of condensation. Never sort of took much notice of it, but for the last sort of 3-4 months, it's been fairly bad for the first sort of 10-15 minutes until it sort of warms up and gets some sort of temperature in it. And it's the same out of the exhaust pipe. So I'm thinking it's had a hairline fracture in it, and we've sort of leaked a bit of water on shutdown because of the pressure in the radiator, in the cooling system. I don't know how much water it's leaked out. I couldn't tell you there, but I have noticed too, when I drained the oil the last time, I did notice some coolant in it. And I actually thought that I might have been leaking a little bit. Well, you can sort of get leakage out through your studs because they go straight into the water jackets. But I did seal them up fairly well with silicone. But I might have thought it was actually leaking out of the back here for some reason. I thought, a little bit of water's just getting through, and I wasn't sort of too concerned about it. But they're all telltale signs to what was really unfolding over time. And even here, guys, I'll show you this. I've had... this wouldn't have happened overnight either. I've had condensation build up under the tappet covers too. That just doesn't happen, you know, in an instant. That sort of, to me, looks like it sort of happened over time, sort of that milky sort of appearance. So yeah, it's and then obviously, you know, upping the boost is just, yeah, it was too much for it and it failed. So yeah, it's not good. This bores all the block's been bored out 40,000ths up from standard. So anyway, I want to make a mention, guys, that the head gaskets, look at the head gaskets on it, they're perfect. So we haven't had any detonation issues, and that was my biggest fear before I pulled the heads off. I really thought I'd done a sort of my tune was playing up or something was going on, but it was nothing to do with the tune, guys. I know that if you get a slight bit of detonation, it'll just push these composite gaskets apart like nothing. You know, you don't get a second chance with them. That's a lot of the reason why I run the composite gaskets, is for that reason. I don't want to run steel gaskets and sort of mask up something that I'm not aware of, and then end up sort of blowing holes in pistons and ruining your motor. So if we did have an issue with the tune, whether it been fuel or timing for whatever reason, these composite gaskets will just pop out like nothing. But if the tune's good, they'll hold up to the boost that I'm running without a drama. So very interesting there, guys. Now, why that is so thin in the bore there, maybe because of core shifting when they casted the blocks. I'm not sure, but geez, that to me, that looks awfully thin. So I would have really thought that'd be a little bit thicker there, considering it's only, it's 40 thou up. Imagine going to 60 thou. Crikey, you'd be near paper thin, that. Be unbelievable. Now the heads, guys, I think they're okay. I think they're fine. That one there is the one that had the piston let go in it. And look at it there. It's a little bit beat up. But I've got a funny feeling if you clean that one up, sort of deburr it and sort of clean it up, and I'm guessing you'd have to do it to all of them now. You couldn't just do it just to one. I'm not an expert on the heads as far as repair work goes to aluminum heads, but I'm not even sure if you could weld those bits up there and sort of clean that one up. I don't know. I'll have to find out, but I'm going to get them done. I don't think I'll bother touching them. And I may even have a little bent valve here or there too. So I want the valves checked. We may even have to skim a little bit off the surface here to get them flat again if they're slightly, who knows. But I want them checked over and sort of fixed up. So, But anyway, it's interesting, guys. That was an incredible thing that happened there. I really, really surprised me. Fancy the bore going like that. That's unbelievable. It's completely bent that rod right around, It actually moves quite well on the journal. So we've just had a bore failure and obviously destroyed the piston because of the hydraulicking effect. And that's what's happened, guys. Well, I've got another block, so it's not all lost. And that's had all eight sleeves. It's been re-sleeved, so it's all eight cylinders are done. And that's the one that I've got in the machine shop with the 355 stroker crank to go in. So that's a relief, you know, knowing that now when I go to put this other motor back, you know, it's going to be a lot stronger in the bores. It's around 90 thousandths thick, the sleeves. So it's even thicker than that, the factory cast steel. So we're putting a decent sleeve in, and we shouldn't run into any issues like that now, guys. So that's fantastic. I knew these were a good little block for the level that I'm chasing, but geez, when it first happened, it sort of had me thinking, oh, maybe the Holdens aren't up to it. But no, it's all good. It's all good. Cast pistons, geez, they look fantastic. They look incredible. It's like everything, guys, you keep a good tune and keep that detonation away. It's amazing how much power you can make out of them. It really is surprising. But if it goes pear-shaped in the tune, well, that's the end of them. All right, folks, well, I'll pop one up soon. That's the damage. So it's not as bad as it looks. It'll all be good in the end of the day. I'll soon get that other one going in time and get it all up and running, and yeah, it'll be fantastic. Okay, folks. Catch you later.